It's a kind of early Americana setting, and you know, there's also a sense of this exoticism to it too, because it's not an early American setting that we've ever seen before. So there's that combination of using that they wanted from the beginning, this idea of using traditional instrumentation, traditional film scoring techniques, but also using alternative instruments, world music instruments, and being open-minded enough to draw from everywhere in space and in time, in the history of musical instruments and also the geography of musical instruments.
If we're thinking about a homestead theme, well, that's a very kind of upright piano, strong string section, brass. I mean, there's a kind of standard or expected quality to that. And then we started to inject the things into that that we thought would make it quite unique. We used some pre-Columbian instruments that reflected the landscape around the characters. We used a lot of unusual string guitar instruments. Things that were kind of primitive or folky that we also put into the refined world of the orchestra. I mean, that's the great thing about a movie like The Good Dinosaur, that the possibilities are endless because it's a magical alternate place.
Through our music, we hope that people feel the journey that Arlo makes, in not just the physical journey, but the character arc that the way he grows as a person. I may call a dinosaur person, which he is to us, and the way he grows from someone who's full of fear and unable to grow to someone who's accomplished what his father challenged him to accomplish, to make his mark, to be something bigger than himself, to get past his own fear, to see the beauty in life, and to have courage. And it's, yeah, we worked really hard to say that musically and to bring you on that journey. So I really hope people feel it with us.